What landmass would I go to the land of black? What would I go to?
Africa, right?
That's what we're taught, right?
Look at that sun. Let me see.
Right.
You look at this sign, right? It says Neo Scipio Africana. This is where you get the term Africa. You get America. America best picture. This is what you get. America. Look at these pictures. You
say that's right. You think you descend from them? That's what I'm saying. So my action guilt, what's your nationality?
White.
No. I'm gonna show you something, white nationality of one. Because I'm actually doing more according to the Bible, and that's what I'm talking about. It's really out of here, and then I'm going to go according to the Bible. There's 18 nations, right? If this book goes all the way back to Adam, shouldn't we be somewhere in that village we need to find out?
Isaiah chapter 1 verse 3, the ox knows its own.
The ox knows its own. The ox is the man who knows his own.
And the ass is that master's crib.
The ass is another, it's like a donkey. He knows his land mass, right?
But Israel, uh-huh.
Israel
don't know. My people do not consider.
He said God's people don't even consider. They never consider, not once. Who we are. What happened that we the only people don't know who we are? And they can go back to their land, man. They can go to Ireland. They can go back to Israel. You know, they can go back to Italy. Why do we go back? Africa is a continent. There's 54 countries there. What country do we go back to? It's a problem, brother. Let me show you how, you know, give me Jeremiah 17. This is what happened to us. And that's why we can't tell. We the people in the book about it. That's your nationality, not only Israel.
In Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 4, and thou, even thyself.
Check this out. This is Jeremiah. He said, thou, even thyself. God is prophesying, but God showing him something that even himself, right?
So this continue from thine inheritance.
He said, we're going to be discontinued from his inheritance.
That I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thine enemies.
This is who we're serving right now, our enemies. They the ones that took me Psalm 83.
Thine enemies in the land which thou knowest not.
We didn't know this in that master first. You think you're on stage.
For ye have kindled a fire in my anger.
Because we kindled a fire to God because he break his commandments. He gave us laws. He never gave us a religion. He gave us commandments. Never gave us Baptists. Never gave us Pentecostal. Never gave us the whole wickedness and all of that. He gave us laws. That's it. Good.
Which shall burn forever.
That's what we're suffering right now. Check this out. This is what happened to us. Start at 2.
Psalms chapter 83, verse 2. For lo, thine enemies make a tumult.
Those same enemies that stripped our heritage, stripped our language from us, and said, those enemies make a tumult. A tumult is like a family gathering. Right? They came together. Watch. Good.
Said, and they that hate thee. Have lifted up the head.
Say they became proud. And they became in power, right?
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
They have taken crafty, like a lot of counsel against us, right?
And consulted against thy hidden ones.
We are the hidden ones, right? Because we don't know who we are. Right?
They have said, come, and let us cut them off from being a nation.
That's heavy, that's in the book. It said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation.
That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
We will never remember that we're the Israelites right now. All these people came together. And they said, let's cut those guys off from being a nation so they don't remember that they're Israel, right? Give me Genesis 32.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. For they have consulted together with one consent.
They all came together. They all came to one agreement, right?
They are confederate against thee.
They completely agree.
The tabernacles of Edom.
I said the tabernacles of Edom. When you look up the Bible, the tabernacles of Edom is the so-called white person. That's his lineage. He's the Edomite. So when you see a white person, he's not white. He's not killing the shrimp. They Edom. They like red. That's what that word Edom is. Red.
And the Edomites.
Israelite, the Ishmaelites, or the Amorites. So all of them came together, go ahead.
And Moab.
Moab is the Chinese name.
And Hagarene.
The Hagarenes are African. Those are another a tribe of Africa. Show me that one. Now, even the Africans are the same. So we got Africans. Go ahead.
Jabal,
that's more Africans.
And Ammon.
Ammon is Japanese.
And Amalek?
Amalek is the so-called white man that's in the land that's in it. He's saying he's a fisherman. That's not his nationality. He's an Edomite. Good.
And the Philistines.
Philistines are more African. Like, all these people came together just to strip your heritage away, to make you not know who you are. Just think about it. We the only people don't know who we are. But guess what? Can we finish that off?
With the inhabitants of Tyre.
Uh-huh.
Assar is also joined with them.
That's
they have helped the Syria. Children of Lot.
Uh-huh. Selah.
Let me
show you why they want to strip that from you. Genesis 32, verse 27.
Genesis chapter 32, verse 27. Uh-huh. And he said it to him.
Now, this is our forefather Jacob. Jacob wrestled with an angel, and the angel blessed him and gave him a new name, right?
What is thy name?
He said, what's your name, Jacob?
And he said, Jacob.
Uh-huh.
And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob.
He said, your name ain't gonna be called. The word Jacob means a planter, a trickster, right? He said, your name ain't gonna be called that no more.
But Israel.
He said, but your name gonna be called Israel. And he's gonna tell you why your name gonna be called Israel.
For as a prince had thou power with God.
He said, you're a prince, and you have power with God.
And with men.
And with your brethren.
And has prevailed.
And you mean you're gonna win it. That's the prophecy. That's why they don't want to let you know who you actually are. Because we're winning. You want to know how you win? Let me go to Bible chapter 28, verse 1. Matthew 19.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1.
Now check this out. This is the agreement that we had with you. Right?
And it shall come to pass if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So Moses brought the children of Israel out of Egypt, right? He took them out, he split the Red Sea, brought them into the wilderness. This is what God told him to tell them, right? Go ahead.
To observe,
fly, brother.
And to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day,
uh-huh.
That the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
So he told the Israelites, he said, if you keep all the commandments of the Lord, you're going to be above all nations. Not going to be the head of body. God never created us to be equal with anybody. He created us to be above. See how big and strong we are? Just compare you to another white man your age or Chinese man. They're all beneath. They're not physically stronger than it. They don't look as good as it. Even when we get older, we look better than when we're not on drugs or, you know, marijuana, stuff like that, right? Good. Here's the flip side to
that. This verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou would not hearken,
he said, if you don't listen,
unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, and the statute which I command thee this day, that all these curses,
he said, all these what?
All these curses,
he said, if you don't do it, curses go come on, right?
Shall come upon you,
uh-huh.
And overtake you.
Uh-huh.
Cursed shall thou be in the city.
He said, and one of the curses is you're going to be cursed in the city.
And cursed shall thou be in the field.
You will curse in the fields, in the cotton fields. It's only pertains to us. We're the only people. How did we get here on this side of the earth from west coast of Africa? How did we get on this side? What mode of transportation? Check this out. This is one of the curses.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
He said the Lord is going to bring you into Egypt. Now, when we was in Egypt, we was in slavery. And that's what he's talking about. He said the Lord will bring you into slavery again.
With ships.
He said, but this time you're going with cargo slave ships, right?
By the word whereof I spake unto thee.
He said, the same way I'm telling you, the same way it's going to happen.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
He said, you're not going to see your homeland anymore either.
And there,
when you get off those slave ships,
you shall be sold unto your enemies.
He said, you're going to be sold to your enemies.
For buying men.
Slave man.
And buying women.
Uh-huh.
And no man shall buy you.
No man's going to be anybody. What did that happen to you? Up with us, right? Who was he talking to? Deuteronomy 1:1. Let's see who he talked. Let's see the audience. He's not talking to everybody.
Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Who are we talking to?
All Israel.
We're talking to the Israelites. So what's your nationality? He didn't talk to the blacks, he was talking to you. So what did that make you? Didn't your ancestors go through that? What did that make you now? What's your right now? Next, we know you're Israelite now. You're not black, not African, you're Israelite. That's your biblical nationality. Give me Deuteronomy 10 and 12.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12.
This is the key, though, because, hold on. You believe in heaven and hell, right? Of what they told you, heaven and hell. Heaven is going to go to you. Give me Matthew 19. Check this out.
Matthew chapter 19, verse 16. Uh-huh. And behold, one came and said unto him.
Now, this is one came of Christ, right?
Good master, what good thing should I do that I may have eternal life?
He said, he wants to see how good he has to do to get into the kingdom, right?
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good?
So Christ said, why are you calling me good?
There is none good but one, that is God.
So he's giving all praise to the Most High God. He's showing you that there are two distinct different people. Christ is not God, God is not Christ. Christ is the Son of God.
But if thou wilt enter into life,
he said, if you want to get into the kingdom,
keep the commandments.
Do what?
Keep the commandments.
That's the key. That's the commandments. We was never taught the commandments. We never taught the commandments, right? It's taught like 10 commandments, right? One of the commandments is give me Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. Check this one commandment.
It's Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day.
The what?
Remember the Sabbath day.
That's in the Ten Commandments, but most churches don't keep the Sabbath day. You know what the Sabbath day is?
To keep it holy.
Uh-huh.
6 days shall thy labor and do all thy work.
Uh-huh.
But the seventh
but
day.
The one thing,
but the seventh day.
When is the seventh day? Huh? Son? Where are you phone at? You got your phone? Pull up your calendar.
That's in Spanish.
In it thou shalt not do any work.
That's what you're supposed to do, bro. It's a holy day. It's a day separate from all the other days. That's just one law. What about the shrimp? Yeah, I know you're from New Orleans. I know you're from the crabs and all that stuff, right? Check this out. You eat pork too, right? You pay pork to check this out.
The Leviticus, chapter 11, I'm sorry, 1.
Yeah, 12, 1, 7, 7.
Leviticus, chapter 11, verse 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron, saying unto them, speak unto the children of Israel.
We are the children of Israel. That's showing you from the beginning, and then we're going to go to the end and show you that it's still, it never changed. Right?
Saying, these are the beasts which ye shall eat among all beasts that are on the earth.
Find out your system, get a flight. Get a book, get a system of life. Look what he got. Good.
Verse 7.
Uh-huh.
And the swine. Though he divide the hoof and be covered with it,
uh-huh.
Yet he chew not the cud.
Uh-huh.
He is unclean to you.
Unclean to the Israelites, right?
Of their flesh shall ye not eat, them, and their carcass shall ye not touch.
His flesh will not touch these, right?
They are unclean to you.
He's saying it twice. He's unclean to us, listen. Right?
These shall ye eat that are in the water.
He said, this is what you're supposed to eat, all that's in the water, right?
Whatsoever has fins and scales.
You have to have fins and scales. Crawfish and crabs and stuff don't have fins and scales. Even catfish. Catfish have fins. They'll have scales.
That's right.
That's right. They bottom feed, right?
In the waters
how many kids? Y'all know how many kids there is now?
Wow.
What?
Oh my God.
So,
Revelation chapter 21 verse 10. And he carried me away in the spirit to a great high mountain and showed me that great city.